So we finished the first memory, and now we're going to go to the second memory. And we already cleared out the enemies this way. And this is where you would fight the pursuer the second time if you failed in the original spot. And I believe Binhart will be over here. Yeah, there he is. Through this memory. I thought that he appeared again here. But maybe that's after we clear the area. Oh well, let's clear the area. Okay, and you don't want to do this lockstone because it fills the area with poison. Hit that lever down so you can get to this plank. And if you make that jump correctly, you get to this spot. Oh my goodness. We just died. Okay, we'll get back to this spot. Okay, and since we already died in here, it looks like he's here now.
Yeah, I know who saw. My homeland, I know.
All right, so let's go and try to get to that spot again. Okay, this time we rolled around the giant and then attacked him. No, I wanted to do this, not return to the bonfire. Oh crap. Not about that guy falling down. There's another item we can get by falling down. Oh yeah, right there. I can't remember what that is. And then there's another item up this ladder. So we'll come back to the memory to get that item. I think that's it. And by collecting these souls of the giants, it helps you in the last boss battle. Not the last one, but the one that you fight King Vendrick. I think you need like 5 of those, and it makes the fight a lot easier. So we'll just do this and get out of the memory and come back in and grab that item right there. Okay, so inside this memory, you come back to this spot, and then you just fall down here. Alright, and we'll just warp out of there and take on the next memory. Okay, so from this bonfire again, let's go down this ladder. And we already killed the 3 enemies that stand in our way to get to this spot. Make sure that you wear the King's Ring to open up the door. Leads you to the final bonfire in the Forest of Fallen Giants. And if you go down that way, there's that corpse, there's a twinkling Titanite, I think ×2 down there. So we're going to stick with this setup and take on the boss. I'm hoping we have enough spells to take on the boss. If not, we'll just use an amber herb. Okay, so we're in the memory of Jay. And there's 2 summon signs. What we're going to do is we're going to summon this one, which is Hugo, Benhard of Hugo. And right when we do that, we're going to run through the fog gate, and hopefully he doesn't die, because if he doesn't die, then we can talk to him in the other memory and get the trophy. So we're gonna cross our fingers and hope he doesn't die. So you just run way over here where this giant is. Watch out for the rolling head. And then take on the boss. Oh, that was close. Alright, and Benhart didn't die, so we can talk to him and finish his quest. And we already have tons of bonfire ascetics, so we really don't need to go back and get that bonfire ascetic, but we will get the divine blessing right here. Or no, it's an old radiant gem, never mind. Okay. Alright, and we'll complete this memory. Get the soul of a giant. Complete it. And the last soul of a giant, I believe, is that large dragon in the dragon shrine. So we'll have to kill that dragon. So right now we're going to go back to both memories in the Forest of Fallen Giants and talk to both people, Drummond and Benhart, to finish their quests. Okay, so we're back in this memory. And we're going to talk to Drummond, and hopefully if we get it right, we get a trophy.
Take these. I think you may just need them. Don't ask me why. I just do. Be gone with you.
Cool. So we got that trophy. So now we'll go and talk to Benhart, and hopefully we can complete his quest also and get another trophy. Alright, so since he survived 3 boss fights, he should give us his sword and we should get a trophy.
We have no way to death a good many times. My dear friend.
Alright, so we did it all correct and we got the trophy. So now we're just going to Homeward Bone out. And the only thing we have left now is to fight the dragon and dragon shrine. So we can get another soul of a giant. And then fight King Vendrick. And kill him. And I think after that we get another trophy for killing him. And then we'll talk to Kel from the mansion, see if he gives us his helm. If not, I think we have to beat Nishandra and Aldia and complete the game. And then we'll talk to him and then complete that NPC quest. Because we need a spell, I believe, from him. And then after that, we will do the all the DLCs, starting with the Sunken Crest. And then the old Iron King, and then the third one, the Frozen one. I can't remember what that one's called, but... Alright, so right now, I'm actually going to warp back to a bonfire, and we're going to do a bunch of soul farming. We're going to keep killing the last giant over and over and get tons of souls. We'll just do it one more time on camera. And then we'll do it another time, I think when it's NG plus 7. And it shows you, to show you the most amount of souls you can get. Alright, so again we're at the Forest of Fallen Giants in the fourth bonfire area, the place unbeknownst. And we're going to burn a bonfire ascetic and take on the last giant again. And the cool thing about using a bonfire ascetic is that every memory, I believe, is affected. So you can go to each memory and pick up the items. Oh yeah, and down below there's that twinkling titanite that we have to remember to get as well. Okay, so we're inside the memory, and don't summon anybody. Just take them on by yourself. We're using the Great Resonant Soul and the Soul Spear. Hopefully that's all we need. Alright, so yeah, it goes through 8 Great Resonant Souls. And then we'll pick up everything here. Oh yeah, Divine Blessing. So it's a Divine Blessing when you get to New Game Plus. Make sure the giants are all dead. Good. And then we'll pick up that bonfire ascetic, and then we'll just keep repeating this process until we get to New Game 7, and I'll show that so you can see how many souls I get.
Wait, who are you again? Fate brought us together for a reason. Take these, and may they help you on your travels. It seems that who are you again? Who are you again?
Okay, so I was wrong. You don't have to kill Nishandra to get his helmet. You just have to kill the last giant. That's the last boss you have to kill. So we can actually now go back to Dragon Eri, or no, Aldia's Keep, and finish this NPC quest. So that's what we'll do. Okay, so we're back here. The reason why I went to that mansion is I went to Majula to level up, and then I thought, well, maybe I'll just talk to that guy just to see if he'd give me his helm, and he did. So now we'll go here.
Fine work. This is my thing.
discuss our next mark. I want you to kill one more. Your target is Felkin the Hexer. As proof, bring me that. Would you? Yes, but he will be formidable.
And we already have that, so we'll just talk to him again. You always say yes, and you have to be hollow, remember, when you talk to this guy.
Yes, that's the feather. God, your reward. What do you? You've been good to me. Come on. These are for you.
Alright, so now he's a merchant, and you can only talk to him, like I said, when you're dead. And he sells some nice items. I think we'll buy all these Black Witch items. This. And other items as well. So anyway, so that, and next time I record, I will show the Last Giant New Game Plus 7. I believe you get about 540,000 souls, and that's what will begin our next video. And then after that, we'll take on the giant dragon and then King Vendrick. All right, thanks for watching.